As you already know, the rule of thirds technique is a placement technique that moves our subject into one of those intersecting lines in our rule of thirds grid pattern. We want to use that same rule of thirds grid pattern to place our background behind our subject in a way that looks more interesting to the viewer. To get an idea of what to look for and how to do this with the grid pattern, let's go over to the computer and take a look at some images. Well, here we are in our screen, and I wanted to show you a couple images that display, again, the background and how to adjust the background behind our subject. Here we have a student who is sort of standing on a little dirt pile here on our site, and you can see that the background is slightly positioned below his waist. Now, if I use a grid line that shows our rule of thirds, and this is basically just our crop tool that automatically gives us the rule of thirds grid lines, you can see that this bottom horizontal line that's part of our grid pattern is lined up with the horizon. And this is the idea. We actually want to use one of these two horizontal lines in our rule of thirds to line up the horizon line behind our subject. So this is placement. This is what I mean by that. And to give you a better understanding, I also wanted to show you, here is the bottom horizontal line in yellow. Here is the top horizontal line in red. So simply by aligning these lines with a horizon line, you'll have a much more balanced composition. Here's the same subject here, and you can see that I've placed the horizon line on the top grid line. You can see it's pretty close. It's not perfect, but it's fairly close to that top horizon line, and I've divided this into equal thirds. Again, if I wanted to have done this a little better, I would have probably put a little higher, but that's not bad. That's pretty close. And as you can see, it changes the composition quite a bit. I have another image. Here's another one with the subject sort of on this black top here, and she's crouched down, and then if I drag my rule of thirds grid pattern over it, you can see there it is. It's right on the top horizon line. And that is how I divide up my horizon line into the rule of thirds grid pattern. So now that we've seen a couple examples of how to place that horizon line at the top and the bottom lines in the grid, it's important to make choices in your photography this week. Now, the reason we want to create a background behind our scene is because we're starting to create a story in our photography. And by including a background behind our subject, we are creating a scene for that narrative. By including a background, you are starting to tell the viewer what's happening to the subject in this picture. By arranging the interesting areas in the background, you are showing the viewer the most interesting parts of that scene. So you need to choose a winner. Does the scene have an interesting sky? Or you have a body of water? Or are you on a hike that leads to a great view? Whatever is the most important part of your scene, again, should take the majority of your frame. At this point in the semester, composition is really the main focus. So it will probably take a little bit more practice with the camera. I would highly recommend going out there with the camera a little bit more this week. This composition technique is going to take some practice. Stick with it, and I promise you will be rewarded with some really amazing shots. I'll see you in video 2, and don't forget to answer the questions in the multiple choice.